plow through your opponents with the Babolat Pure Arrow Tour. As the heaviest racket in the Pure Arrow family, the headlight balance and aerodynamic beam helps it play fast and whippy. Featuring an updated Cortex dampening compound making the feel slightly softer at impact, this racket is perfect for players looking for the benefits of a heavier racket without losing the easy acceleration crucial to spin and pace. First up, we have Eric. Now, I know you love to load your shots with tons of spin. How did this racket work for that?
Yeah, so I hit with the standard version of the Pure Arrow. I really like that frame, but I wish it had a little bit more mass behind it. So I really enjoyed this Pure Arrow Tour. It was great. It was still pretty maneuverable for me, but I also got a ton of power and spin from this frame. One area where I struggled but did get used to was I really had to accelerate on the ball constantly to make this a lot more predictable. But whenever I did that, I was rewarded with a ton of heavy spin. So that was a really great aspect of the racket, and I really enjoyed that feature. If I decelerated, it just became a little bit unpredictable for me. Transitioning up at net, I thought this racket was really easy to maneuver. I got really easy depth from this frame, but I was a little bit disconnected. I didn't hit as many drop volleys as I usually do. On the serves, I did get a good amount of power, and I really loved the spin with this racket. I could hit a ton of kick serves, and that was really fun for me. And overall, if you really like to mash the ball and you're super aggressive with your swing and you want to play like Rafa, this is definitely a racket to try out.
Next up, we have Sean. Now, you were on the global review of the Pure Arrow that came out last summer. How did this compare? How did this heavier model compare and work for you?
Right, so I really like the regular Pure Arrow, and I feel like even though this racket adds almost 20 grams of weight, it isn't that much more demanding in the court. It only bumped up about 3 swing weight points to like roughly 327, which is still fairly manageable for me. So even though it's the tour version, I still feel like intermediate to advanced level players will be able to enjoy this frame. I did notice if I wasn't swinging and accelerating through the ball, as Eric mentioned, I wasn't getting the same easy depth I got with regular Pure Arrow, but when I did, if I can match the same swing speed, I was getting rewarded with a lot more stability and a lot even heavier ball, which is complimentary because with the Pure Arrow, you can hit a pretty heavy, spin-heavy ball. My favorite area to play with this racket was on serve. I really like heavier rackets on serve because I feel like when you can get that mass moving through the air and make it feel natural, you just get rewarded with really big pop. I think that more advanced players will enjoy this racket as opposed to the regular Pure Arrow because you can really feel that stability on like higher balls and when people hit heavier and on serve and stuff. But if you can't handle the swing weight, then I don't know if I would recommend this racket. It's just not quite as easy to use as the regular Pure Arrow.
Next up, we have Troy. Now, I know you used the previous version, and we just finished playtesting the extended version. What stood out for you with this racket?
Yeah, I playtested this and the Pure Arrow Plus. I liked both of them a lot. It was a pretty close tie between the two of them, but this one just drawed me in a little bit more. As soon as I picked it up and started swinging from the baseline, I really love the mass of this racket. It's not quite the heavy spec like, you know, my V-Core Pro or maybe your RF97. But it's just borderline, I think, perfect weight. You know, had just enough swing weight, just enough mass to feel stable from the baseline and up at net. Where we're exchanging balls back and forth, you're hitting heavy pace, and I felt like I could block the ball back relatively easy. One thing I noticed with this update compared to the last one that we play tested, just a little bit softer feeling, a little smoother on contact, and I just felt a little bit more connected to the ball. That's one thing that I was really surprised with. Typically, the Arrow is having a thicker beam. I get a lot of disconnect, but I really felt pretty dialed in considering all things. So I love the control aspect considering the head size and the open pattern. This was just a really fun play test for me. Really don't feel the need to customize this too much, maybe just a smidge of weight, slightly higher swing weight. I leave the stock grip on there just because it's already a firm racket, don't need a leather on this one. But you know, these modern type of rackets and the feel of this one, it you know, really surprised me.
I know in the past I haven't really gelled with the Pure Arrow line, but this year changed that. I loved this playtest. I loved hitting with this racket. From the very first hit, it just felt seamless to get balls nice and deep, penetrating the court. I had zero issues with launch angle, and it felt just great in my hands. As Troy mentioned, normally we both kind of tend to like a little bit heavier of a spec. The swing weight could have been a little bit higher, but it worked just perfectly for me for whatever reason. I loved hitting with it. At net, I honestly didn't think I could miss volleys when I had this racket in my hand. There was one day I was practicing volleys and I swear it was like a magic wand. It was stable, it fell right out in front, nice and maneuverable, so no issues at all whatsoever there. And as Sean mentioned, I really like serving with this racket as well. I do know that I've found a lot of pace from the Pure Aero line when I go after my first serves, and it was no different with this Pure Aero Tour. Now, there's always one thing that happens with me when I hit with a Babolat racket, and I tend to slap a little bit. That came out tiny bit on my returns, but it's honestly not a huge problem because the racket does have some nice control. It does have that added spin built in. And you know what? Sometimes it's just fun to slap the ball. So no complaints from me. All in all, just a really great play test. If you haven't tried the Pure Aero Tour before, definitely give it a go if you're a big hitter looking to attack the ball. We strung up our playtest rackets with Babolat RPM Blast 16 gauge at 53 pounds. We also use Signum Pro Yellow Jacket 16 gauge at 53 pounds. And if you want to learn more about this racket and many others, please visit us at Tennis Warehouse, Tennis Warehouse Europe, or Tennis Only.